At first, we need to load a typical meteorological year, TMY. Using a TMY, we take into account effects like clouds in the morning, etc. We select a point and click at the tool. To adapt the orientation to the time we are interested in, we need to change this table. Therefore, we click and drag. Afterwards, we can store it as a CSV file. The graph represents the ratio of the annual incident of solar radiation for a particular orientation to the annual incident of solar radiation for an optimally orientated surface. Now let's see the effect of the shadows. Watching the other graph, we can see a movement to the east. The best orientation is 156 degrees now, because in the afternoon we have shadows at that point. Let's use the Relief tool to add a bigger mesh than the Google Earth Terrains one. The marker is in the center of the model. We select a region, leaving the marker more or less in the middle. Now we have a mesh of the mountains and we can see its shadow on the roof. We deactivate on ground because it projects shadows on the plane z equals 0. And we deactivate the layers Google Earth Terrain and Snapshot because with less objects in the model the calculation will be faster. We can add several construction points on the roof to find out the best orientation of the whole roof. Scillion will make an average to return the best orientation of all points. Here we have a graph of a selected point. We can as well select a face and an edge. We obtain the same graph but with two lines that represent the orientation of the panel following the edge with several relative tilts. The blue line often is the direction of the edge not looking towards the sun. The other graph is the SOF, surface orientation factor, versus the relative tilt. We can see that the best relative tilt following the edge is 9 degrees. Let's try with another edge, the other side of the roof. Here we can see that there is a panel orientation almost in the optimum position. This position has a relative tilt of 30 degrees. Thank you for watching.